Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Monday, the feast of Saint Cecilia. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Behold, now she follows the Lamb who was crucified for us. Powerful in virginity, modesty her offering, a sacrifice on the altar of chastity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who gladden us each year with the feast day of your handmaid, Saint Cecilia, grant, we pray, that what has been devoutly handed down concerning her may offer us examples to imitate and proclaim the wonders work in his servants by Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. In the third year of the reign of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon came and laid siege to Jerusalem. The Lord handed over to him Jehoiakim, king of Judah, and some of the vessels of the temple of God. He carried them off to the land of Shinar and placed the vessels in the temple treasury of his God. The king told Ashpenaz, his chief chamberlain, to bring in some of the children of Israel of royal blood and of the nobility, young men without any defect, handsome, intelligent, and wise, quick to learn and prudent in judgment, such as could take their place in the king's palace. They were to be taught the language and literature of the Chaldeans. After 3 years' training, they were to enter the king's service. The king allotted them a daily portion of food and wine from the royal table. Among these were men of Judah, Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. But Daniel was resolved not to defile himself with the king's food or wine, so he begged the chief chamberlain to spare him this defilement. Though God had given Daniel the favor and sympathy of the chief chamberlain, he nevertheless said to Daniel, "I am afraid of my lord the king. It is he who allotted your food and drink. If he sees that you look wretched by comparison with the other young men of your age, you will endanger my life with the king." Then Daniel said to the steward whom the chief chamberlain had put in charge of Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, "Please test your servants for 10 days. Give us vegetables to eat and water to drink. Then see how we look in comparison with the other young men who eat from the royal table, and treat your servants according to what you see." He acceded to this request and tested them for 10 days. After 10 days, they looked healthier and better fed than any of the young men who ate from the royal table. So the steward continued to take away the food and wine they were to receive, and gave them vegetables. To these 4 young men, God gave knowledge and proficiency in all literature and science, and to Daniel, the understanding of all visions and dreams. At the end of the time, the king had specified for further preparation. The chief chamberlain brought them before Nebuchadnezzar. When the king had spoken with all of them, none was found equal to Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. And so they entered the king's service. In any question of wisdom or prudence which the king put to them, he found them 10 times better than all the magicians and enchanters in his kingdom. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Glory and praise forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever, and blessed is your holy and glorious name, praiseworthy and exalted above all for all ages.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, praiseworthy and glorious above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you who look into the depths from your throne upon the cherubim, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you in the firmament of heaven, praiseworthy and glorious forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Alleluia, alleluia. Stay awake, for you do not know when the Son of Man will come. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus looked up, he saw some wealthy people putting their offerings into the treasury. And he noticed a poor widow putting in 2 small coins. He said, "I tell you truly, this poor widow put in more than all the rest. For those others have made offerings from their surplus wealth, but she from her poverty has offered her whole livelihood." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today we celebrate probably one of the most popular saints of the church, Saint Cecilia. Of course, Saint Cecilia is the patroness of music, no, and musicians, no. But you know, she according to the write ups that I read, she's probably one of the most historically discussed saints, no. She's a 3rd century saint, no, in Rome, and she has a very interesting story because you know, she wanted to remain a virgin, no? And she did not want to get married, and she wanted to serve the Lord, no. And she belonged to a noble family, no, to a rich family, and then eventually she was of course given into marriage, but she converted her husband, no. She was able to convert her husband, and I think even her brother-in-law, and all of them died martyrs, and they're all saints of the church, no. So I guess that was the power of her person. That was the power of her grace, no. And she was one of the most studied, according to the write-ups that I read. She's one of the most studied saints, no. And then she was buried, I think, in the catacombs of Saint Calixtus. But later on, Pope Pascal I, the 9th century, around 6 centuries later, discovered her body, and it did not decay, no. And so there's a lot of miracles attributed to her, and a lot of devotion to her, no. And I just want to share that story about her, no. And hopefully people will get interested to read more about her. Maybe just 2 points for a reflection. Again, a very beautiful gospel. We read this several weeks back, no, from the Gospel of Mark during one of our Sunday masses. But I'd like to invite you to reflect on 2 points. No, number one is the Lord said the poor widow, the widow's mite, donated out of her poverty. No, siguro mahalaga natin pag-isipan kung ano ba yung kahulugan nun sa atin na tayo ay magbibigay, maglilingkod sa Diyos, tayo ay to love and to serve nga, di ba? Magmamahal at maglilingkod sa Diyos na out of our poverty. Hindi yung sa ating masasabi natin kung ano yung sobra, kung ano yung galing natin even, ano? But the poverty of our person. Ano yun? What is that poverty of our person with which we will serve the Lord? And part of the question is, ano yung sakripisyong gagawin natin para mapaglingkuran at mahalin natin ang Diyos. That is giving out of one's poverty. Hindi yung sobra, not our surplus, not our wealth, or not our money, but our very poverty, yung ating pagkatao. No? Then the second point for reflection is, sabi nga, nakwento ko na ito sa inyo, pero maganda rin siyang pagnilayan, di ba? Yung sabi ni San Ignacio, tinanong niya isang Jesuita, ano bang pwede nating gawin para sa Diyos? Tapos sabi ni San Ignacio, wala. We cannot do anything for God. What can we do for God? Nothing. And then Ignatius said, but what can we try? What can we attempt to do for God? Everything. Diba, napakaganda? And that's also giving out of poverty. We cannot do anything for God and yet we will give everything to God. Na lahat ibibigay natin sa Diyos ng buong buo. At lahat iaalay natin sa Diyos ng buong buo. Yun yung pagbibigay natin out of giving out of our poverty. So today let us pray, let us ask the Lord to grant us this grace, no, for us to be able to give everything to Him. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Together now, let us offer our prayers and petitions. The widow in the temple gave everything she had. Her generosity humbles us. Let us be generous in our prayers for others, responding to God who gives without ceasing. To each prayer, a response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
That as a church, we may be generous enough to share not only from our abundance, but from our own poverty. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That public officials may be freed from greed and abuse of power. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may unite their sufferings with the sufferings of Christ. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And again, let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we also especially remember during this month of November, all the souls of the faithful departed, the souls in purgatory, also offered during our November Masses. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us offer our panalangin para sa halalan 2022. Diyos aming Ama, sa paghahanda namin para sa aming halalan 2022, nagtitiwala kami sa iyong pangako na magpapadala ka sa amin ng mga pinunong naaayon sa iyong puso at diwa. Panginoong Jesus, bigyang inspirasyon mo ang lahat ng naghahangad ng katungkulan upang maging mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na uunahin ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami. Lalong-lalo na ang mga mahihirap, mga nasa laylayan at mga mahina. Higit sa anumang interes na pansarili o para sa grupo. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na maghahangad ng katungkulan upang tunay na maglingkod at hindi paglingkuran. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na may integridad at tunay na malasakit. Banal na Espiritu, tanglawan ng aming mga isip at puso nang aming makita ng malinaw ang mga tunay na pangailangan ng aming mga kapwa Pilipino at kung ano ang pinapangako ng mga kandidato at ang kanilang kakayahang isakatuparan ng mga ito. Nang aming piliin ang tama, mga pinuno na tunay na mamumuno at maglilingkod, mga pinuno ayon sa iyong sariling puso at diwa, mga pinuno na magbubuklod at mamumuno sa amin, upang gawin naming lahat kung anong higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami at para sa iyong higit na kaluwalhatian. Ama, Anak at Espiritu, Ikaw ang Diyos ng buhay at pag-ibig, ang Panginoon ng kasaysayan, naway makasama ka namin sa oras sa ito ng aming paghahanda para sa darating na halalan. Amen. Birhen ng Fatima,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
Immaculada Concepcion, Patron ng Pilipinas,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the offerings we bring in celebration of blessed Saint Cecilia win your gracious acceptance, O Lord, we pray, just as the struggle of her suffering and passion was pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give ardor to their faith. So to their endurance, you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle, the victory is yours, through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration. And we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend now a few moments of silence, again, contemplating God's word and also contemplating the Holy Eucharist. And together now, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to strengthen our faith and hope. We pray for all health workers, protect and sustain them. For those who passed on, reward them with eternal life and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe and guide them, most especially our leaders. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who died in agony and loneliness. Be their consolation. Embrace them and their families with your love. We pray for families who suffer due to loss of jobs and income, and for all who experience anxiety and fear. May they know they are not alone. Inspire us all to come together in fraternal love, for and service to one another. Guide our experts, instruments in your healing hands, to continue to develop effective vaccines and cures for this virus. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, and our Divine Healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. O God, who bestowed on Blessed Saint Cecilia a crown among the saints for her twofold triumph of virginity and martyrdom, grant, we pray, through the power of this sacrament, that bravely overcoming every evil, we may attain the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat. Have a good day ahead and have a good week ahead. Thank you po.
Purihin ang Diyos at magpasalamat tayo sa Kanya. Ipapatupad na po natin ang ating Ale Kapwa Legacy Program ng Caritas Pilipinas, Pamilya Feeding Program at Educational Assistance Program para sa ating mga kabataan. 6 na mga dioceses ang tatanggap ng tulong para sa Pamilya Feeding Program. Ang dioceses ng Kidapawan, Cotabato, Capiz, Dumaguete, Infanta, at Libmanan. Bawat pamilya po ay bibigyan natin ng 300 pesos every day. At ang bawat diocese ay pipiliin natin ang mga beneficiaries, 60 families for every dioceses. At itong tulong ay ibibigay natin for 6 months. Para naman sa ating Educational Assistance Program, 10 mga dioceses ang bibigyan natin ng tulong. Ang dioceses ng Buntok, Basilan, Hulo, Marawi, Libmanan, Infanta, Dumaguete, Capiz, Cotabato, at Kidapawan. Bawat diocese po ay pipili ng 50 na mga kabataan. At ang bawat bata na ating tutulungan ay bibigyan natin ng 10,000 pesos. At maliban dyan, ay tutulungan pa natin na magkaroon sila ng mga gadgets para sa kanilang pag-aaral. Ang lahat po nito ay ating ginagawa upang ang ating mga kababayan ay maiangat natin sa kanilang paghihirap at mabigyan natin ng magandang kinabukasan ang ating mga kabataan. Tulungan niyo po ang Caritas Pilipinas. Magtulungan po tayo para sa ating bayan. Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko.